Good morning, brothers and sisters. We are here another morning, and I am Pastor TJ Beatty coming with our morning Bible study. We're still in the book of James, chapter 2, starting at verse 14 on today. I will not be reading it in its entirety. I will just be reading and going on as we learn. Let us pray. Most gracious eternal Father God, we love you. We praise you. We acknowledge you, God. We thank you for your presence and your power. Ask, Lord, that you be with us and keep us on today. Allow us to hear your word, understand your word, and use it in our lives as we go as Christians, as men and women of believers of God. So we thank you, God, for all that you've done and all that you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so we're talking about faith. Without good deeds is dead. Now, verse 14 says, what good is it, dear brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith, but you don't show it by your actions? Can that kind of faith save you? Suppose you see a brother or sister who has no food or clothing, and you say, goodbye and have a good day. Stay warm and eat well. But then you don't give that person any food or clothing. What good does that do? You can't say that you have faith and you don't put it to action. Your faith does something because you believe it has to be activated. Faith without works is dead. They work together. They work hand in hand. What are you saying, TJ? In this section right here, James is telling us, when we're talking about the poor, he's saying that if someone shows up and they don't have something, they're without clothes, they're without food, then that's the opportunity that your faith becomes active. And your faith does what? It gives them clothing. It provides food for them. Your faith brings them into your home if they don't have a place to stay. Your faith becomes active, and because your faith is active, their faith grows. Their faith increases. Their belief, because you are that moment that God has answered their prayer. You're the opportunity when God is allowing their faith to increase through your actions. Faith does something. Faith isn't all about, hey, I believe. Faith means, guess what? It has action behind it as well. Because I know, because I've been through situations in my life, because God has done things in my life, because God has spared me, because if God has made a way, then guess what? I have to activate my faith as well and do things as well. Because I believe. Because when I see something when I come across an individual who's struggling or hurting or going through a situation, I know then I'm believing that God is going to do amazing. And because I believe that God is going to do amazing, at that moment, I'm stepping in and saying, here you go, my brother and sister. Here you something to eat. Here is food and clothing. Here's a place to stay for the night. I'm going to go put you in the hotel for the night so you have a place to stay and take a shower. That's when my faith becomes active. So verse 17 says, so you see, faith by itself isn't enough. Unless it produces good deeds, it is dead and useless. Your faith has to produce some type of good deed. If not, it's dead. What you're saying about what you're telling people that, hey, that you believe that you got faith, it's dead. It's not active. How can I believe if I don't see as well? I have to know that, guess what? That faith is real. How do I believe? It's active right here. James tells us that faith has to have some type of work, that it has to couple with work. You just can't believe. It just can't produce good deeds. It's dead. It said, faith by itself isn't enough unless it produces good deeds. Is your faith producing good deeds? What are you doing today that shows, or what are you doing consistently that your faith produces good deeds? You're saying that you're believing. You're saying that you love God. Faith also shows that you are an example of Christ, that you represent Him. If you love Him, because you're going to show that you love God by doing His works with other people. By taking care of the poor, taking care of the needy, taking care of those that are without. That's what that faith also says, that I'm going to be an example of Christ. Verse 18 says, now someone may argue, some people have faith, others have good deeds. But I say, how can you show me your faith if you don't have good deeds? I will show you my faith by good deeds. You say you have faith, for you believe that there is one God, good for you. Even the demons believe this, and they tremble in terror. How foolish, can't you see that faith without good deeds is useless? James is here, and people are saying, you know what? Hey, yeah, you saying you got faith. Even the demons believe. You know what I'm saying? Even the demons believe. You can say you believe all you want. The demons say they believe. How do you distinguish yourself between the demons and you being a man or woman of God? Because, yeah, Satan believes, guess what, in God. But the thing about it is, guess what? Your actions, the demons, guess what, don't believe in the power of God. The demons don't believe in taking care of the poor. The demons don't believe in providing for the poor. But guess what? God does. That's how you resemble him. That's how you stand out and show that, guess what, his faith, your faith is a reflection of Christ. Verse 21, don't you remember that our ancestors Abraham was shown to be right with God by his actions when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see, his faith and his actions work together. His actions made his faith complete. See, Abraham, guess what? When God gave him this command of he needs to offer his son, Abraham just didn't listen to what God did. Abraham got up and put that into action. He moved. He heard God, and he moved and did what God told him to do. There was some action behind. Faith causes you to do something. There was action behind what he heard from God. He did it, and guess what? God answered. God's word, God showed that his word is true. Guess what? Faith and the works both happened. And guess what? It resembled something. It did something. It says, verse 23, and so it happened, just as the scripture says, Abraham believed God, and God counted him as a righteous person because of faith. He was even called the friend of God. Wouldn't you love to be called a friend of God? Because you're so, you listen to God, you move like he say you do, you show that you have faith. Because this is a different type of faith. You know that Abraham had to have faith. He had to stand on his faith. If God tells you today to offer your son, your daughter, he's telling you that, hey, this is what I want. Do you have enough faith? Do you believe in God enough? Do you have enough faith that you're going to stand on what God said, on his promise, and do exactly what he says that he asked you to do? Some of you, guess what? You're getting paid on today. You're getting paid this week. You're being paid daily. Are you saying, you know what? I'm going to have enough faith. I'm going to pay my tithes and be honest and be faithful because I know God is going to bless me. God is going to keep me. He's going to make sure that I'm never without. You may not be the wealthiest person in the world, but guess what? You will never be without. You would never be without. Ain't that a good feeling to know that you? I know you've been. Have you been in a life where you've been without, where you didn't have a place to stay, you didn't have food on your table, you didn't know where your next meal was coming from, you didn't have lights on, you didn't have the cable, you didn't have gas in your car. But you know, because I'm going to be faithful in my giving, in my tithe. I'm going to be faithful to God. I know that, guess what? I will never be without. Because if he has, he'll always replenish. Because he sees your faithfulness. Verse 24. So you see, we are shown to be right with God by what we do, not by faith alone. Verse 25, watch right here. Rahab, the prostitute, is another example. She was shown to be right with God by her actions when she hid the messengers and sent them to safely away by a different road. Now, you know, Rahab had to have faith. Here she are. She lies, and she tells, and she hides these men because she knew that her life would be spared if she does it. She had to have enough faith. Guess what? She was wrong for telling a lie, but she had faith. Guess what? Knowing that if I do this, my life would be spared. She had to have that type of faith. She had that type of faith. That she lied to the king and hid these men, you know what I'm saying, the messengers, and her life was spared because of it. That's faith right there. Yeah, if she hadn't done this, she possibly could have died. She could have lost her life. But she had enough faith knowing that these were the men of God. And she knew that, she told them that God is going to give this land to you. She knew, she believed it. She said this to them. And because of their faith, God spared her. She did something that some a lot of people wouldn't do. A lot of people, you would say, no way, I'm not hiding these messages. I'm not going to put them in my house. I'm not going to, these people may come in and kill me. But she had faith. And just as, it says verse 6, just as the body is dead with their breath, so also faith is dead without good works. Faith is coupled with works. You have to do something. You can't just be talking about it. You got to be about it. Yes, I believe. But what do you do when you put in that situation where your faith has to become active? What do you do when you're in the fight of your life and your faith has to become active? What do you do when you're in a situation that you don't know how you're going to get out of? You have to have faith. You got to believe. Faith without works is dead. What do you do when you come across the next person and they're telling you, hey, this, I don't have this. Does your faith become active and you say, no, here you go, my brother and sister. Come eat with me. Come sup with me. What do you do? Is your faith active today? How is your faith going to be active? Are you going to live this day forward and say, you know what? I am going to live without a shadow of doubt. And guess what? My faith will be active. Hey, guys, I hope you heard something today in the book of James in chapter 2. To close out this entirety, that's going to help you be a stronger believer, going to help you walk closer with Christ, and going to help your faith become more active. Hey, guys, I love you and be blessed.